I'm Lynda Wilson, State Senator for the 17th Legislative District in Clark County. The issue of domestic violence isn't what brought me here to Olympia, but as someone who witnessed domestic violence as a child, I've taken an interest in improving our laws having to do with domestic violence. And so, in 2018, I filed a bill to promote what's called electronic monitoring with victim notification technology. The concept is simple. If a victim of domestic violence gets a protection order from the court, the judge could place the accused abuser on the electronic monitoring, and that monitoring can be leveraged to create a perpetual geo-protection zone around the victim. The technology exists to do just that. The protection zone moves with the victim, which is far more than a protection order written on paper can ever do. I wanted to give victims a chance at regaining a sense of self-control and peace. No more looking over the shoulder, wherever they go. Because if the accused abuser comes too close, the victim gets an alert in real time using an app on a mobile phone. The bill didn't pass during the 2019 session. Then 2 days before Thanksgiving of 2019, a young mother named Tiffany Hill was murdered in Clark County. Tiffany had recently obtained a domestic violence protection order against her estranged husband. He violated that order 64 times in less than a month and had even planted a tracking device on her car to aid in stalking her. On November 26, their youngest child's birthday, he waited 30 minutes in a parking lot of Sarah J. Anderson Elementary School in Vancouver until Tiffany and their three children left the building. He drove over to her car, blocked her in, and even though the kids were in the back seat, he shot into the car and killed Tiffany and seriously wounded her mother. Then he took off and killed himself following a police pursuit. I never met Tiffany Hill, but it just broke my heart when I learned her story, because it was obvious this bill could have made a difference for her. She was a former Marine. If she had been alerted that he was close at hand, I have no doubt she would have taken steps to protect herself. She most likely would be alive today, and their three children would not have become orphans. I realized that this bill had to become law, that it couldn't wait any longer, and that we needed a hero to get it through. Tiffany Hill, who served her country with honor as a Marine, became that hero. And the Tiffany Hill Act is now law.
Tiffany and I served on our PTA board at Sarah J. Anderson together. We spent nearly every day together at the school working and doing our fundraising events.
Tiffany was my co-president of the PTA at the school that I work at. I'm a second grade teacher at Sarah J. Anderson Elementary.
Tiffany Hill is my best friend. We've been best friends for a few years. We met at a Grow and Learn with our kids, and it was an instant connection that we had.
I met Tiffany through my wife. They met at our children's school together, and through the process of moms being friends, the husbands became friends, and we got close with their families. So that's how I met Tiffany.
I wish this bill would have already been a law to where it could have helped Tiffany out, and hopefully she would have still been alive if this was already a law. But now that it is a law, it's going to help other families with domestic violence situations to where they can get away from their perpetrator and go to safety and not be able to look over their back every second of their lives, wondering if they're around the corner ready to pounce on them or to break the restraining order. Amazing to be able to be a part of it, to come and see all the steps that it took to get this to where it is today. And to know that I was a part of it.
It was a pretty incredible experience. It's not something I thought I would ever be doing. It was a long, exhausting process, but I'm just hoping that it can help other people and prevent the same tragedy from happening again.
I'm extremely happy that in this world that we live in today, it was able to be passed bipartisanly and unanimously. I think working together is what made this work. And I hope going forward, that even if we can save one family from going through what Tiffany's family went through, everything will be worth it.
It's a bittersweet experience. I mean, I'd rather have nothing to do this, and I'd rather be home with my best friend eating cheese and doing other things, but to think that now, like, more eyes are open, that this is going to help another woman, man, anybody, this affects everybody. So to think that this is opening eyes and more people are willing to step forward and stand up and say, this is happening to me, it's a pretty good feeling to know.
I am still heartbroken for Tiffany's family and her friends who miss her every day. I am sad that this technology couldn't be available to Tiffany when it likely would have saved her life. But I'm so grateful for the unwavering support this bill received from so many in the community. The friends Tiffany made through Sarah J. Anderson Elementary, the people who rallied around Tiffany when they discovered she was a domestic violence victim, So many in Clark County were determined to see this bill become law. I've said all along that this bill needs to become law this year. The members of our community, Tiffany's friends and loved ones, made this happen. We can all be glad for what this law will mean to victims of domestic violence going forward. Even though she's gone, Tiffany Hill will continue to serve.